Mom cuts daughter's hair after dad got it braided without her permission. The snips could be heard loud and clear, even from down the sidewalk, so it must have been echoing in the little girl's ears. The neat braids fell on the ground and the plastic beads bounced and rolled everywhere. Amongst the angry yelling was the heartbreaking cries of the helpless daughter, stuck in the middle of a parental battle. Chase poked his head through the Alabama daycare door and surprised his three kids with a huge smile and surprise visit. It hurt how much he wanted to see them but how little he could. So, that way was going to be simple, but special. They piled into his care and he drove them to the hairdresser. He hated the stereotype of deadbeat dads. So, aside from getting his sons a haircut, he asked the hairdresser to braid his little girl's beautiful locks. This time, the long twists ended in adorable white beads. The giggles were a clear sign, she loved it. He was about to find out, however, that the mom did not. As they drove home, he noticed something, the hairdo seemed a bit tight. They were trying to get their baby's hair to grow out. Would it affect things? Chase threw her another warm smile and thought, we can just unbraid it later if it's not right. Scissor, however, never entered his mind. As soon as the girl stepped out of her car, the mother, Malia, came barreling over. Rage poured from her eyes and a vile tone seeped from her words. Even if it was cute, the mom wasn't going to stand for it. She screamed, I didn't give no permission. The basic reason for the lash out. The mom hated that another woman did her girl's hair and the father didn't ask if it was okay. Chase did his best to control his anger, but her nasty words were already falling on little ears. The kids looked to both parents, confused about what was happening. What happened next, he couldn't believe it. Malia stomped into the house and came out with a pair of scissors. She roughly grabbed a fistful of braids and started chopping them off. Beads fell and bounced on the ground. The tears that fell from the tiny girl's eyes now streamed in full. The pain and fear on her face were clear. Chase tried to step in, but the woman was in a rage and had something sharp. He told her to stop, but it only made her reaction more volcanic. Braid after braid got snipped until there wasn't anything left but ragged leftovers sticking out of the girl's head. Malia then threw the scissors at Chase. There the fractured family stood. The ex-wife screaming, his kids crying their eyes out, and him helpless to do anything but film the scene. He had plans to get full custody and, hopefully, this would help. As the mom dragged the kids away, the only way he could step in was to go home and post the video. Reactions started to pour in, including from mom. His side was simple. He wanted to do something nice for his kids. However, the mom's side started to unravel in a toxic, fuming war on the father. Chase felt the worst stab when he saw a new video from Malia. What she said was unbelievable and the core of her actions would be unforgivable. I'm not gonna lie. It was cute, she said. Chase had to walk away from his computer before he punched it. The traumatic event was purely to get back at Chase and hurt him, through hurting their girl. But the mom wasn't going to end there, she was about to drag others into her sights. The unapologetic fury continued as she criticized and cursed the person who did it, that it was too tight and the girl's skin was bulging around the braids. The internet exploded back. The video had already gone viral, but the public wasn't going to sit back and let her get away with it. They let her have it. Why didn't you just unbraid them? You've traumatized your kid. Things like this can affect them forever, what does this do to the child's spirit? That is abuse, I will pay for your lawyer, man. And while most people would have been quiet, Malia decided to double down and send out more livid responses. Her return punches went from defending what she did and throwing curse-laden insults, to disabling the comments on her social media, and then opening them up again for another wave of digital assault. One final comment brought another aspect into the limelight. The woman had been complaining she needed a job. So, Chase had saved her money and time. She could have used that as a temporary break and chance to job hunt, but she chose the toxic route. The father stared at his screen and typed a message to his kids. He was going to do everything he could to save them and bring them into a safer home with him.